storms are not to be taken lightly, especially because there are two of them, and they're going to impact so much of South Louisiana so close together. This is primarily going to be a water event, but because of the storm surge and the flooding, the first 72 hours is on you. And that is because the second storm comes in so close that there may not be much of a window when we can fly search and rescue.
Stay weather aware, get your supplies together, follow the news, follow what you guys are putting out because you're our partners in this, and we'll get through this.
The state of Louisiana is preparing for back-to-back impacts from two significant tropical systems just 2 days apart. Thanks for joining us here on the AccuWeather Network. I'm meteorologist Jeff Cornish. Hurricane Marco and Tropical Storm Laura are both headed for the Gulf Coast. And as you already saw, Laura has already unleashed on the U.S. Virgin Islands. Heavy rain, big waves, strong winds in Puerto Rico yesterday. Here's the view of the hurricane as Hurricane Hunter, of the tropical storm, as Hurricane Hunters flew over Laura this morning over Hispaniola. Reports say over 1,000 people have been evacuated, over 100 are in shelters, and 14 communities have been cut off by Tropical Storm Laura's downpours in Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic. We are dealing with, again, a strengthening storm, not just in the case of Laura, especially after it crosses Cuba. We expect more strengthening into the Gulf, but Marco has become a hurricane today, and we have two significant threats to the central Gulf Coast on the map. And one will come in, and about 48 hours later, we expect to see another make landfall. So we're looking at Monday and Wednesday as the days of landfall. Most likely, Marco first, then Laura, but in between the two, heavy rain, flooding problems, and so forth for the central Gulf Coast. And here is the satellite estimated radar, as if there were a network of radars across the entire Caribbean. This is what you might see. With heavy rain for some, especially into the area of the Gulf of Mexico, our first concern, Hurricane Marco, which became a hurricane today, is moving north-northwest at 13 miles per hour. It split the gap between the Yucatan Peninsula and Cuba, and it has been moving into an area with still some wind shear, but it has been able to strengthen as that wind shear is beginning to decrease, and the water is very warm. We expect to see significant impacts here as a hurricane making landfall on Monday afternoon or evening, most likely into Monday night, and then it will produce tremendous rainfall into southern parts of Louisiana. Hurricane warnings are in effect for areas around Grand Isle, the mouth of the Mississippi River. Hurricane watch for New Orleans, and Baton Rouge is under a tropical storm warning associated with this at this point. Here's our wind forecast with the AccuWeather local storm max of up to 100 mile per hour wind gusts near or east of the point of landfall. But many areas in a slightly less populated zone south of New Orleans could see 80-plus mile-per-hour gusts and a significant 60 to 80 mile-per-hour gust forecast for the big city of New Orleans, along with 4 to 8 inches of rain. Storm surge problems also will accompany this as well. And overall, this storm, Marco, has an AccuWeather Real Impact Scale rating of 1, as we do expect to see a true Category 1 hurricane bring many of the risks that you would associate with a Category 1 hurricane to the central Gulf Coast. And New Orleans is in the high-impact zone here for this storm. Water is very warm. We have been dealing with also Tropical Storm Laura, as we showed you the footage earlier. Hispaniola has some big mountains, and that has kept this storm in check. It's a little stronger than it was recently. The past 24 hours spent most of its time at 50-mile-per-hour sustained winds. Now we're up to 60-mile-per-hour sustained winds as it is moving to the west, and it will pass over part of Cuba, a relatively large landmass, but Cuba is flatter than Hispaniola. So that will probably keep it in the ballpark of a 60, 65 mile per hour tropical storm. And then we expect this to strengthen to a hurricane, possibly a Category 2 storm, as it approaches the central Louisiana coast, possibly the western part of the Louisiana coast, somewhere between Lake Charles and areas to the east there along the central part of the coast. Strong winds here. This is insult to injury. 2 days after an area of 60 to 80 mile per hour or 80 to 100 mile per hour gusts, we have a similar zone at the greatest risk of strong winds yet again. And the same zone after seeing 4 to 8 inches of rain, we'll see another 2 to 4 on top of that from Laura. And this one could actually bring some drought relief to the northeast, at least the interior northeast, wreak havoc on the state. Firefighters shared this perspective of what it's like trying to get around near the CZU Lightning Complex fire. An incredibly dangerous and scary time as flames surround the roadway and total across the West, over 1.4 million acres have been burned by active blazes. Meteorologist Adam Del Rosso is joining us with more on the Southwest forecast. It's a hot one, and the fires continue, Adam.
Jeff, good evening. Yeah, pretty much every state through the Rockies and westward has an ongoing major fire, especially around the Bay Area, where we have both the SCU complex fire, but also the LNU complex fire. Both of those combined, more than 600,000 acres burned. They are less than 20% contained. So firefighters still have a lot of work left to do here. And Mother Nature not really going to help out much either, because the forecast, generally speaking, is going to remain warm and dry. And that means red flag warnings indicating that high fire threat through the Bay Area northward into south central Oregon. We've got those warnings in place across Utah and into southeastern Wyoming as well around Laramie as we head through the rest of today and into the upcoming week. Now, there are some spotty showers and storms across the region as what's left over of Hurricane Genevieve continues to work northward. But because most of the area is dry and there is that threat for lightning, we will need to watch out for additional fires to be started by those dry lightning strikes. But where we do have some of those rain showers, they are coming down pretty heavily. Notice across southern Nevada and into parts of Arizona, more so around Prescott. That's where we do have some flash flood warnings ongoing.